Today we're going to introduce abstract simplicial complexes, which we're going to view as a specific type of hypergraph later in the video. First, a finite abstract simplicial complex is a pair Vx, where V is a finite set and X is a set of non-empty subsets of V that satisfies two properties. The first property is that every singleton is an X. That is, for every element in V, the set containing only that element is in X. The second property is that X is closed under the operation of taking subsets. The members of V are known as the vertices of the complex, and the members of X are known as the faces of the complex. In this video, we're going to visualize a complex by representing a vertex and a face with one vertex as a dot, a face with two vertices as a line, a face with three vertices as a lightly shaded triangle, and a face with four vertices as a darkly shaded tetrahedron. Let's look at an example of a complex. If our set of vertices is 1, 2, 3, and our set of faces is this, we have an abstract simplicial complex, as every singleton is a face, and every non-empty subset of any face is also a face. If our faces were this instead, we would not have an abstract simplicial complex because we would be missing one of the singletons. Also, if this was our set of faces, we still would not have an abstract simplicial complex. That's because we'd be violating the second property, which is closure under the operation of taking subsets. Face 1, 2, 3 has a subset 1, 3, which is not a face. Moving on, an equivalent way we can define an abstract simplicial complex using just one property is that it's a set X of non-empty sets closed under the operation of taking subsets. We can then define the vertex set to be the union of all the sets in X. We refer to the sets that are members of X as the faces of our complex. Since the vertex set is just a union of the sets in X, any set in X is a non-empty subset of the vertex set. Also, since the faces are closed under the operation of taking subsets, and every member of the vertex set is in at least one of the faces, we automatically get that the singletons of elements in the vertex set are faces, meaning that our two definitions are equivalent. Let's cover a little more terminology. First, a facet of a complex is a face that's not a subset of any other face. In this complex, the faces 1, 2, 3 and 2, 3, 4 are facets. Next, we define the dimension of a face to be 1 less than the number of vertices in that face. As an example, the dimension of face 1, 2, 3 is 2, and the dimension of face 2, 3 is 1. We can also define the dimension for the entire complex by letting it equal the maximum dimension of any of its faces. The dimension of the complex shown here is 2. Next, a subcomplex of a complex Vx is an abstract simplicial complex V prime X prime, where X prime is a subset of X and V prime is the union of all sets in X prime. Basically, we form a subcomplex by selecting some of the faces present in the parent complex, and then whatever vertices happen to be in those faces, those vertices become the vertex set of our subcomplex. Note that because we require the subcomplex to be an abstract simplicial complex itself, X prime has to be closed under the operation of taking subsets. As an example of subcomplexes, the abstract simplicial complex C, shown on the right, is a subcomplex of D, shown on the left, because the faces 1, 2, 1, and 2 are all faces of D, and they're all closed under the operation of taking non-empty subsets, meaning that C is also a complex. As our next piece of terminology, if C is an abstract simplicial complex, we define its K skeleton, C sub K, to be the subcomplex of C whose faces are all the faces in C with dimension at most K. Notice that the K skeleton will always have the same vertex set as the original complex because all zero faces or singletons will be present in a K skeleton. Let's think about what some skeletons look like. If we take the zero skeleton of a complex, we get a complex formed from just the singleton faces of the original complex. If we take the one skeleton of a complex, we get what essentially looks like a graph of the original complex. The graph this resembles in its visual representation is called the underlying graph, which is what we get by taking our vertex set to be the vertex set of the complex and the edge set to be the set of one-dimensional faces of the complex. Let's look at just one more concept relating to subcomplexes. The link of a face F and the complex C, which we denote in this way, is the subcomplex whose face set is the set of all faces of C that satisfy two properties. First, they must have an empty intersection with F, and second, their union with F must also be a face in the complex. Note that in this case, we're defining the link as an abstract simplicial complex using our second equivalent definition of abstract simplicial complex, which is that it's just a set of non-empty sets that are closed under taking subsets. Let's look at a concrete example. In this complex, the link of face 2, 3 is the following set. Notice that face 2, 3 is contained in two facets, 1, 2, 3, and 2, 3, 4, 5. Also, there are elements in the link that, when united with our face, give us one of the facets, although not all elements in the link will do this. The union of our face with 1 from the link is the facet 1, 2, 3, and the union of our face with 4, 5 from the link is the facet 2, 3, 4, 5. Also, notice that it's not necessarily the case that the union of a face with all elements of its link is also a face, as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is not a face in this complex. Our observations can suggest a way to find the link of a face. First, list out the facets it's contained by, and for each facet, find the set of all faces that use only the vertices in the facet that are not in our face. In other words, the non-empty members of the power set of the vertices in each facet that are not in our face. The union of these sets will be our link. As an exercise, let's find the link of face 1, 2 in this complex. What facets contain 1, 2? They are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2, 5, 6. Starting with facet 1, 2, 3, 4, the set of vertices that are in 1, 2, 3, 4 but are not in 1, 2 is 3, 4. Here are the faces that use only the vertices in 3, 4. Next, for facet 1, 2, 5, 6, the set of vertices that are in 1, 2, 5, 6 that are not in 1, 2 is 5, 6. Here are the faces that use only the vertices in 5, 6. Combining these all together gives us the finished link of face 1, 2. Another observation we can make is that the link of a facet is always empty, as there are no faces that could be added to a facet to create a larger face, or else the facet would not be a maximal face. Moving on, let's relate all these concepts to hypergraphs by viewing complexes from the perspective of hypergraphs. An abstract simplicial complex is really a hypergraph whose vertices are the vertices of the complex and whose edges are the faces of the complex. We can think of abstract simplicial complexes as downward closed hypergraphs. Notice that these hypergraphs cannot have any isolated vertices, because in an abstract simplicial complex, all singletons are faces. So all singleton edges are present in our hypergraph, meaning we don't have any isolated vertices. Let's go over some of the other concepts we covered in terms of hypergraphs. The dimension of a complex from the perspective of a hypergraph is the maximum size of any edge. A subcomplex from the perspective of a hypergraph is an edge-induced subhypergraph satisfying the property that the edges are closed under the operation of taking subsets. A facet from the perspective of a hypergraph is a maximal by inclusion edge. With the hypergraph perspective in mind, K-skeletons are special types of partial subhypergraphs, or spanning subhypergraphs, because they would involve all vertices of the hypergraph and only a subset of the edges. A zero skeleton is what we would get when we choose to keep just the singleton edges. A one skeleton is what we get when we choose to keep the edges of size at most two. A two skeleton is what we get when we choose to keep the edges of size at most three, and so on. The underlying graph from the perspective of hypergraphs is a two section. Finally, the link of a face F from the hypergraph perspective is the set of all edges in the hypergraph that are not adjacent to F and that, when joined with our edge F, form another edge in the hypergraph. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe. Have a great day.